Hi, today we're going to introduce some ground techniques that CAPAP Academy is exploring together with Professor John Machado from Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu.
Okay, so now here we have the choke hold, okay, happening. Okay, it's a common mistake. People try to go this way. As I go this way, I'm choking myself because I'm turning against the choke. Each time I turn this way, I'm choking myself. Okay, so here the principle of the gi is that the gi will teach you the direction that you must go to escape. Okay, because I have to open the choke up. When you have no gi training, the person is just hugging you. If a person is just hugging me, okay, now it's okay. You can go this way, that way. It doesn't matter. There's nothing on my neck, so you can go any side. All right. So here now, when you have the choke, okay. What I'm gonna do here, I'm going up to escape this way in favor, okay? So I have a few elements happening here. My hip, okay, and the arm control. Okay, the most important being first the arm, just to stop the motion. See, if I get worried just about the body, but do nothing about the arm, he can choke me very fast, okay? So first I'm gonna trap the arm, to stop the elbow, the hand, okay, like that. And now I'm escaping into the person. So now doing this whole movement, I'm not being pressure on my neck, okay? Now I can go all the way to the side, okay? Which now I have already a joint lock situation here, okay? And I can pursue with the throw, finishing, okay, with a strike or with an arm bar, all right? Okay, so now here we have the knife situation, okay? So very similar to the choke, okay? The escape will be on the same side, on the opening, okay? But now even more important so, because you cannot afford any mistake, because now it's a life threatening. One mistake, you're dead. So here, as you go for your control, okay? It's very important, as you go here, I'm actually pushing the knife in at first here to release the pressure in case it's too tight. Okay, if it's too much here, as you go for the control, you actually push it in. So you open a little gap. As soon as you do that, you open the knife. Okay, so be, okay, one, two. Now my whole body, my hip, my shoulders, okay, I will step to the opening here. Now you're back on the same situation. We have the angle here, I have the leverage. Okay, now at this moment, the knife can turn into him. Okay, you can turn into the opponent, or I pursue to the ground. Once you go to the ground, okay, you have the control, you can send back to him, okay, can go into a lock, okay, or disarm altogether. All right, so another idea here is a concept that we are developing here, is to use the mount escapes in Jiu-Jitsu, with the knife defense, and stop putting everything together. So it's something that needs to be worked very well, okay, but it's a concept that we're discussing. So here, bang, you can block, okay, and bring directly into our Americana finishing hold, which I already have, or pursue that, okay, with the escape, so keep going for the finishing hold. Or, what you can do here, okay, now as you block, change sides, trap, now the blade is facing the opponent. So now I gotta be really careful, because as I raise my body now, okay, the knife's against the opponent. Okay, so he's stabbing himself, and I'm gonna push very careful into his body. See, so the knife's going that way, okay? Even if the fake knife, you must be careful, because you can hurt yourself. Okay, so one more time. So bang, bang, bang. Okay, hip up, and then I turn into the very careful. And here, okay, the control is still pursuing the finishing here. Okay. Now this is another idea from CAPAP with the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. It's a concept where it doesn't matter how he strikes the knife, or block, okay? One more time. Block. Now I can directly into a finishing hold here, okay, and pursuing with the upa escape up, turning, okay? Now you can keep doing the arm bar, all right? Okay, you have the full Americana on the guy here, okay? The second idea will be to block, switch, okay? Switch hands, so one, two, bring it. Once you get this side, bring your elbow in, so you make sure the knife is pointing at him, okay? And now it's very dangerous even to practice with a fake knife, with a hard knife, you gotta be really careful. Do I use a soft knife, a knife to practice, or keep on the side for now? Because as I do the upa, that's it, the knife goes in, okay? And then you keep turning, okay? And you still have the strike over here, it's over. So it's a deadly escape. So try use a soft knife to practice that safely, okay? But the idea is realistic, is to, it's for real. Okay, the same idea now we'll apply to the gun defense, okay? And it's not a position to be, I don't like to be on the end of the barrel, but here is the same idea, the same mountscape, the same idea of getting out of the range of fire, okay, as quick as you can, being that the priority. Then the escape, the second priority. So here, okay, will be the arms, my arms are already up, as you keep in a mounted defense anyways, working on the gun and on the wrist, okay, pushing to the side as I move my head to the side. So here, you notice that I'm not flat on my back, it's too much grinding on the ground. See, I'm up a little bit, see, so you, that's why the core is important, so you can do this move very fast, okay? One, now two, bring it in, so my elbow, my whole body is coming in, so I point it to him again. So now, the same idea, okay, here, upa, turn, see? And I can keep here, the gun, if the gun didn't fire here now, I can take it away. Okay, so now let's talk about the turtle position, a concept. I mean, can apply any situation, it's a concept, so goes anywhere. And I'm here with Fred, okay? I'm gonna talk about, let's say, the guillotine. Okay, for example, the guillotine attack. Okay, the first one. So my neck will be here. Okay, so my neck's in control. So here, if this arm, I'll have one point, okay? And with my head, will be the second point, okay? So I will go for the takedown. As I go here, I keep rotating in, okay? Like I'm coming to this position here, see? So like this, by facing him, my head facing him, it's already the escape from the guillotine, all right? Because if I follow, I'm throwing him and following myself, I'm putting my neck into the guillotine again in case he insists on the position. So one more time, okay? One, two, three, four, I'm out, okay? The common mistake is to follow. I'll do one time, okay? If you throw and follow your neck into the situation, now I have to restart the escape, okay? If it happens, it's a whole different situation. So is what with this drill right now, you avoid the guillotine altogether. You escape, okay? Now same application from the side, okay? So Fred has I'm on the turtle, the side control. I'll stretch my leg, the back leg, okay? As I stretch the back leg, I have the second point over here. Okay, as I slide my knee inside. So the move, again, one, slide my knee inside, I have the second point. Bang, I'm on top. Okay? Okay, one more time from the other side. Is that, okay, so be one, leg out, okay? As I slide my knee in, my arm is against his body, so I have the two points right here. One, and then like two, okay? Okay, I'm on top, okay? Can follow word combinations, all right? Okay, so now we will talk about the control here on this situation, this specific the side control, and where I'm looking, okay, for control points. So here, and I also talked to Avi and Albert about these, the how stand you have the 2 points, then the application on the ground, how you go from 2, you try to get to 3 and 4, okay? So you're like a pyramid, okay? Or a cube, okay? So like a square. So for example, once you get to a side control, if I have this base here, okay? People, they do a lot of mistakes because they stay too, the legs too close together, okay? And then they're off base this way, you see? So here, what I'm looking for is the arm has one control, see? I extend my leg up, so that give me another control over there on my foot. Plus I have my hip, okay, centered on the ground, okay? And here I lean forward to avoid the push to the back. Let's say you do a rocking chair, Fred. See, to avoid this escape, okay? So I with my foot here, yeah, go slow. See, oh, I'm leaning forward. He's not going anywhere, see? Because I have a good solid position here, okay? With the 4 points right now, the elbow, the hip, and both legs are working, okay? So I have base 1, 2, 3, 4 right now, okay? If he changes, I change. So here, I can switch to the front control here, okay? The arm over the shoulder, so not my knee against the hip, okay? So I have, again, the 4 points, okay? So here, my arms, my knee, and my foot on the other side, okay? If I need to switch this way, okay, same thing, I have the same situation, the leg, this foot, my hip and my arm. And again, I'm leaning forward, because when you're sideways, you have to watch the back push here. So I'm strong here, after I push, I have the control, plus this hand here, you can hold on. That's when you can use the cloth, you can hold on here on his clothes, or you can hook the leg itself to give you extra control. All right, and then you're ready to move on to the mount, okay? Or start operating here the finishing holds. But all of the next position or the finishing will be a result of your control. If you don't have a good control, you have nothing, okay? So one more time. So good drills you can do here, okay, will be from the side control to switch, okay? Square off, switch to this side again. Okay, now back into a cross-face situation. The 4 points again, both arms and both legs, okay? Switching this way again. See, as I'm switching, things are already coming handy here. See, the arm is already outside just because I'm switching, okay? This arm is already vulnerable. So I can go for submission hold here, okay? And then you start, okay? Switch, walk around to the other side, switching from side to side. I have the mount, okay? Square off, okay? Switch this side again. Back to the front again, cross face, okay? So these kind of drills will help you to build this concept of the 3 points or 4 points on the ground. Let's talk about the chokes, the concepts. Okay, that are more important than how many techniques you know, but how well you do the techniques that you know. And the important is to understand the concept of the choke. Okay, so here is my student, Luis Baek. Okay, so a simple collar choke, okay, I'm gonna start from here. Okay, so I'm gonna develop 2 points here of control. Okay, so bring his head here, down. So once I bring his head down, okay, I have my hand, my forearm blocking here, my hand going under, and I have the collar. So if he stays here, of course, I have the finishing. But there it's not, because I only have 2 points right now, he can find the window here of escape, always, okay? Going out that way, which is the opening here. So I bring him down again, right? time. Okay. All right. So now I'll close that window. So you start building the relative position, because no technique is 100% every single time. It's part of the training to build up the realistic approach. So you go for a technique, he starts escaping, you adapt and go to the next step to look for another point of control, and he's looking for another point of another window to escape, and so forth, so on. So one, as I go here now, I'll bring him to the side to close it. Okay, so now violation. He can escape out that way.
Very good.
Okay, so now here, I'll try here, okay, to trap his arm, right? And try look for a better control. I will keep progressing so I can succeed on that choke. Okay, let's work another approach now here. Okay, so as I bring his head down now, I'll step up so I trap him under my legs, under my hips for the choke. And you hold, okay, down. But he can still do the throw, the takedown, and escape. So you keep progressing. I keep progressing on my attack. Okay, that's to develop the relative position. Okay, so one more time. So now I'll look for an even better position. Going this way. One, two, three. So now, okay, back. I have a position because I have too many points in my favor now. So once you start understanding that, you'll be more proficient in your finishing holds and you are helping each other to escape from the positions, okay? Okay, so now we will demonstrate here some drills for to build your reflex against multiple opponents. So very important to engage fast and block your opponent before you get kicked into your head. And you must understand that in martial arts, I mean, especially on the ground, you must have a strong core, okay? Because if you don't, it takes too long to move, too long to react, you cannot perform your techniques. So all those drills are a fun way for you to develop that. So you just take your time, build up little by little, your core will be like stronger than ever. So Luis, start slow, demonstrating, okay? Good. And slower you do, harder it is, okay? So he's bringing his hip really high. So less contact with the surface. So you move easier on the ground. Okay, so you're working everything here. So little by little, you know, you start developing the, you keep the other speed. Back up a bit then. Yeah, vai aumentando a velocidade. Yeah, vai aumentando. Yes. Venha, stay closer. Aqui, bloqueia a cabeça. Isso. Vou tentar te chutar aqui, defende, traz a perna lá. Isso. Sweep nela. Next time, sweep nela, then sweep me right up. Cool. Sweep her. Raspa ela e raspa eu, vai. Huh? When you go here, slow, slow. Then faz comigo e raspa também. Very good. Okay?
Next thing that we are explaining, it's the core concept of KAPAP mixed with skills that we picked up from Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Professor here will show and talk about some applications from the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu along with his student, Luis. And I will later on explain how and Avi will perform the same techniques or based on same principles with combative applications with a handgun. So Professor, please take over.
Okay, Luis. So here we're gonna do some movements, some drills that we use for conditioning to confuse your muscles so your body is ready to react to any situation. So let's start, Luis. The rocking chairs, they're good back and forth. Faz a cadeira, isso. Pode. Switching base. Sentada, sentando indo pra cima, isso. Na minha direção. Okay? So he will use that for many situations. Come here so he can come on top of the takedowns. From the guard, push, sit up. So he's ready to come for the sweeps. Okay? Always facing the target, always moving around, you know, so
Okay. Mais uma vez, deita. Senta, já vai para o esporte. Vendo do tamanho.
So, the idea is to always keep moving, always facing the target, looking for the angles to bring it to the fight or to move away, to keep the dynamics of the situation. You know, you do rounds of that. Okay, so you can do minute rounds, 15 second rest, another minute round. I do like 5-6 rounds. Okay?
Abby will take over now and he will show the same exact move. I'll use the rocking chair into CAPAP applications. Abby is holding the handgun and he's falling back. This situation can occur from many angles. You drop to the floor. And look how Avi is using his core muscles in coming up and falling back down when he's keeping his contact with the target all the time. And he's keeping his sights or his contact with the threat. The direction goes to the same direction that the threat comes from. If Professor is the threat, Avi will sit with the threat and will be ready for that angle every time. And now, he has a contact from this side, so he's responding to this area. And again, we see the same exact move that we've seen before, taken from Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Based on that move, we are moving our core area and falling back and forth, keeping our balance and our target in the same line.
We, for my student Matt, we're gonna demonstrate the training for conditioning. It's very important to get to know your body is your tool, your first tool. So you get to become familiar with it. So all those exercises are designed for you to understand your balance. So you learn to keep the flow. See, because you lose your balance, you have to first regain your balance to be able to do anything else. So it's the importance of this move to always stay, go from one move to the next, stay in balance, watching your form. So you are ready to adapt that flow to the relative position when you need it, okay, in a combative situation. So I'm gonna go through a basic routine that you do at the school. So it's a stretch, but you're also moving using the movements you're gonna use in training. Frog, you know the frog moves. Must do that all in a freestyle mode to develop that, feel comfortable with your body, because this will help you on your training. Okay, thank you, man. Another drill here for your defense on the bottom, for the escapes here, will be to train the upa here. So first Ahmed will do by himself from side to side over the shoulder. So he raises his hip, going over the shoulder, reaching for the ground. So you can do sets, you know what I mean? You can do by time, like a minute each exercise to develop your core, and this is the move that you use in training, okay? And now we're gonna do a variation, that's good. Luis here now, on the side control, okay? Where he'll train to do that move with the weight on top. One, so he can do the same thing. Two, to use it with the resistance. This for conditioning, okay? You can put do with your hand under too, charm under, can work, yes, good. See, he's almost already escaping. Don't escape yet. Yeah, just work the exercise. Good. Yeah. You can switch arms now. To the other side. Oh, see? So these are good exercises to do. The later ones, you bring it to the techniques much easier for your body to perform the technique. Very good. Very good. Okay, now let's talk about the guard here. So I'm the officer. I have the weapon, okay, and I'm fighting this man here on this situation, okay? So if I try to pull the gun from the close guard, the problem is that the range is too close, so it's very easy for him to use his hands and fight for the weapon, and I might be in a very bad situation here myself. So here, to come here, it's too risky. So for small people, for women, you gotta work different angles. So here, what we can do here in this situation, my hand always in front, is to open the guard, so my feet are out of range, out of the field of fire here. Because if you shoot the guy, I'm shooting my legs too, my feet. So here, as I open, I upper, so increase the range, and now I can shoot the leg, or I can go under and shoot him on his groin. And my feet are not in the range of fire. Okay, that's the initial idea. As you develop better understanding of the guard now, would be better to have my hands blocking, open the range, okay? By escaping my hip, bring my legs up, okay? Or just getting my knees together here already. So different approach you can do. So I can block him right away from making it hard for him to reach the gun. Okay, because this shooting. Now it's much better, because I can increase the range, okay? Now I can shoot from here, okay? I can still shoot from here. I can lift my foot, block the arm. Now it's even better, shoot. I have total control here. And here also, I can change. So here, I can push, and now, be in a total different position now to finish this combat. So I can open the range, okay? So just some of the jiu-jitsu ideas now with the gun, combining with capap to try and understand the ground so you don't pull your gun when you're in the range for him to take the gun away from you, okay? Thanks, Luis. Okay, let's cover this idea here. The side control, when you're training in the school or when you're on a street situation. See, when you're training, you control really tight, and you're looking for the openings for the arm, for the chokes, you're more concerned about the control. After that, you look for the finishing holds. But on the street, you can add other elements, okay? So, some techniques that you don't use in the academy every day. So things of this nature, when you bring him up a little bit. See, you get your fist under his spine here. So you push him right on top of put the weight now. So you have the bone hurting him. So a lot of pain compliance, a lot of pain, pressure points on the street is very important. Okay? So that's one thing we can do here. The other thing is to open the range. See, because when you're tight, it's hard to strike. But when you open up, you can not only strike, we have more leverage. But you can use your knees here, okay? Use your knees on him, as well as you can strike at the same time. And as you have that, it's always good to change his angle, because here, you have to always be watching this arm, so this arm don't reach for your groin. So here, it's always good, it's a good choice to push him to the side, so you have a better angle to strike, you can trap, okay? Now you have a total control here, okay? You can strike this guy. Bang. Okay, back away even, bang. Kick, move out if I have to, Okay, so those are some of the street applications you can use here. Instead of just being glued with him the whole time. That's good for control, good for the school, but you're on the street, let's work the idea, having the fist under, pushing, okay? It's a lot of pain compliance here, okay? All right, opening up, use your knees, okay, change the angle, okay? All right? Okay, so you have to keep an open mind. It's not always one range. You can open up anytime you need.